Welcome to the video news of the week. Colebrook's town manager, Sharon Penney, submitted her retirement notice to the selectmen at their meeting on Monday, April 12th. Penney has been the town manager since September 2018 and took on administration and implementation of a $6.4 million infrastructure replacement program, which included long overdue water and sewer replacement work. She said she enjoyed creating an approachable, hands-on work environment with the town employees during her tenure. With the announcement of the passing of Prince Philip this week, the Chronicle looks back at the time that the Duke of Edinburgh visited nearby Lennoxville and Cherbourg, Quebec in 1989. Documented in COAS magazine and preserved in the audio recording made by this reporter, we follow the Prince throughout his May 20, 1989 visit. His first stop of the day was a historical museum where he inspected a line of war veterans, was greeted by scouts, and was serenaded by the Estrie Young Singers. Next, it was off to Bishop's College School in Lennoxville. This proved to be an impressively choreographed spectacle, where the Prince spoke in English and in French to the gathered crowd.
Now, everybody knows that schools are for education. But many people seem to think that the purpose of education is nothing more than to help people to pass examinations. But there's much more to education than simple academic achievement. A full education should also prepare young people for a civilized and satisfying life. And most responsible adults have discovered that there is nothing more satisfying than giving service to others. Le corps de cadets fournit une introduction au plan au plus ancien et plus précieux des services publics.
That evening, Prince Philip addressed the United Empire Loyalists Association, providing an alternative viewpoint to the events of the American Revolution, which prompted the formation of the Loyalists.
And it was in 1977 that the Queen and I visited Philadelphia, and later Boston, in what you will remember was the 200th anniversary of the Declaration of Independence, of what was to become the United States of America. Well, that's the date, and that is the event that stick in people's minds. Yet they were nowhere near the end of the story. Like so much of history, it is usually the winners who get to write their version of what happened. What has come to be known as the American Revolution, I think might more aptly be described as the first American Civil War.
He concluded by speaking of the importance of Canada's future.
I think it would be more than foolish to take Canada's future for granted. You have to work for it. You have to have a vision of a civilized and harmonious community and consciously work towards achieving it.
The complete story of Prince Philip's visit can be found in this week's Colebrook Chronicle.
Stratford resident Milton Paradis was formally presented with the Boston Post cane this past Wednesday. A special event was held at the Fuller Town Hall in Stratford to honor Milton's 96th birthday, and friends and well-wishers turned out in droves to spend time with the iconic Stratford resident. Last year, Milton had been named as the current recipient of the Boston Post cane, a distinction marking the oldest resident of a town, but due to the COVID-19 pandemic, no formal ceremony was held. The selectmen used the opportunity of his birthday this week as a chance to officially present Paradis with the cane and recognize his lifetime of achievements.
Now, I was trying to think of some really inspirational words to say at this, because this is kind of a big deal for us. And I've racked my brain all day. What can I say that would be truly inspirational? And the fact of the matter is that nothing I can say is as inspirational as Milton's life. He has devoted his life to our nation, to our town, in ways that should be an inspiration to us all. And I'm hoping that Milton is in a position where he can hold on to these things for the next century.
He's done a lot for the town, and he's an example for the town. Stratford resident. He played basketball. He was sports. One of the best what was it? Guard?
What's that?
Were you the guard or forward? Basketball.
I played all 5 positions.
Yeah, you know.
It's kind of ironic that I sat under the hall when I had help. I was selectman at the time, the hall burned.
Yep, yep.
And helped have this building built. Right. And here I am today being honored in it due to the fact that, well, I had it reconstructed. So I built myself an old home.
Well, many happy more birthdays, and we're proud to have you as a resident.
Well, I've got 5 more listed.
Okay.
All of them, so I'll be around for 5 more years.
Very good.
Just get used to it.
Thank you.
The weekend begins with a report of a winter weather advisory with heavy wet snow carrying into Friday. Temps range from a high of 39 to a low of 33. Saturday sees things begin to return to normal with a high of 45 and a low of 31, and Sunday temps raise higher still to a high of 48 and a low of 35 degrees. The Colebrook Mohawks began their softball season on Wednesday with a game against Lin-Wood. The Colebrook girls were victorious in their matchup with a final score of 19-4. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.